What is good, guys? Back multiplayers round one. This time, Hai versus Ash Ketchum Gamer. As you can see, game one is going to be a replay, but I have the rest of the series live recorded on Smogtooth with the Smogtooth chat, so don't worry about that. It's going to be coming to you later. Going into the series, Hai is a clear favorite for me. He has way more tour experience. He played in SPL, he won World Cup with Northeast, qualified for Ulti multiple times, and I don't know anything about this other dude. So, gonna favor Hai going into this. And looking at the teams, they are pretty similar. Megaladios on this side, Megaladios on the other side. Then the Rocker is either Heatran or Clef on both sides. The Heatran could either be a Leftovers or a Zemo variant. If the Heatran is Zemo, you can say the same about both teams. Then the Clef is probably Wish support to keep the Heatran healthy. But if the Heatran is Leftovers, then it's unlikely that the Clef has Wish. And also if the Heatran is not Z, then yeah, Gren is most likely Z. Pax is probably Toxic Spikes, which will only affect the Gren, so it's not going to be too effective in this game. Landorus is most likely Scarf on both sides. U-turn Earthquake, it doesn't have HP. It doesn't have to be HP either on Ash Ketchum Gamer's side, because he has a Ladi and a Clef for Zygarde. But on Hai's side, I assume it's going to be HP Eyes. Because Megaladias is way more bulky than Teos, so we can check Zygarde better. And other than that, I think that's most I wanted to say about the teams. I think we can get right into it and talk about the rest of the sets as we go on. So turn one here, Hai can go for rocks if he has them on Clef, but if he has rocks on Tren, then he obviously doesn't have rocks on Clef, and he could go for any. If he doesn't have rocks on this, then he can go for anything that hits these three mons, because I'm pretty sure he's just going to U-turn out here into one of these three. So if Hai has like knockoff or T-wave or anything that hits these three mons, he can go for that. Otherwise, he can go for rocks if he has rocks. Okay, he shows to be T-wave. This makes me think he's T-wave, soft point, Moonblast, and the last slot. It's either Calm Mind or rocks. I'm thinking it's Calm Mind. This actually helps Clefable beat the Heatran down potentially later in the game, especially if the opposing Clef is not Calm Mind. This Clefable can easily win the game for Hai later, but he will have to scout that out. If the opposing Clef is Calm Mind, it's not in his favor to go for a Calm Mind war, because he has a Pex in the back that most likely has Haze, so he doesn't have to go for a Calm Mind war. But we will see later if the opposing Clef and this Clef has Calm Mind. So now potential plays here for Ash Ketchum Gamer depends on his Heatran set. Hai is most likely gonna go hard into the Megaladi. So if Ash Ketchum Gamer has Steelium Z, he can go for that and bop the Ladi. He should run the Kalk, and if it Okos, he can just go for it. Other potential plays is if he has Toxic, he can go for that, which would hit the Ladi, or he can also throw up the rocks. If he doesn't have any of those moves, another potential play here is double into Greninja or double into Ferrothorn, which would both cover the Ladi. I'm 100% sure that Hai is just going to go into Ladi. It just depends on Ash Ketchum Gamer's Heatran set, if he can touch the Ladi or if he wants to pull a double. He does not seem to have a move to hit the Ladi with, because he pulls a double. So this makes me think his Heatran is probably just Taunt, Magma Storm, Earth Power, and I'm not sure what the last move would be. I don't think it's Toxic, because if it's Toxic, he could have just clicked it right there. And if it's Rocks, he could have clicked it right there. So it makes me think that he's probably Rocks on the Clef. So he doubled into Ferrothorn, and now he can get up a spike here with the Ferrothorn. Unless Hai has HP Fire, he's forced out here to switch into a Heatran or into his Clefable. If Ash Ketchum Gamer wants to be super safe, he can switch out here into his Greninja, which would cover Hai going into his Heatran and would also scout for the Latios having HP Fire. If he doesn't fear HP Fire, he can just go for a spike. So Hai does just go into Heatran as Ash Ketchum Gamer throws off a Leech Seed. I'm not a big fan of that play. I think it would have been better to get up a spike there. Leech Seed doesn't really accomplish too much in my opinion. But yeah, now Hai got in his Heatran, and since he didn't go for rocks earlier with the Clef, I assume he's gonna have rocks on a Tren. And Hai is most likely gonna throw the rocks up here. And Ash Ketchum Gamer is gonna have to go into either the Ladi or the Greninja here. If Hai has Toxic, that's also a potential play, which hits Ladi and Greninja on the switch. So either Toxic or rocks here is the play for Hai, depending on his Heatran set. And obviously Ash Ketchum Gamer is not going to stay in here, there's no point, even if he has Protect on the Ferrothorn, because the Heatran could potentially go for rocks, exactly. Greninja was a fine play, even if Hai attacked there, he had the Leech Seed to get some recovery back from the Heatran. So now Haye is most likely gonna go into his Toxapex. He could also go hard into Clefable if he fears the Greninja being Ash Ninja with Z-move too low and Toxapex. But overall Pex seems to be a safe play here. So what Ash Ketchum Gamer could do here if he doesn't have any coverage to hit the Pex with, I guess if he has spikes on this instead of the Pharaoh, he can throw up a spike here, but I'm still thinking he has spikes on the Ferrothorn. So he could either go for spikes if he has that, I don't think he has it, or he can pull a double into something that covers Clef and Pex, which would be a double into Heatran here as a potential play. Or yeah, I guess he will probably just attack, but it just depends on his set. I'm pretty sure Haye is just gonna go to his Pex or Clef, most likely Pex, as he does go into his Pex. Ash Ketchum Gamer just goes for a Dark Pulse, reveals that he's Ash Greninja with Battle Bond, obviously. And from that damage, we can tell that this is a Spadef Pex and that did absolutely nothing. So this is not Choice Pex Greninja, so it's either Z-move or it could be Mystic Water. I'm thinking it's probably Z-move, which makes me think that the Heatran is going to be Leftovers. I don't know if he showed that yet. But yeah, that did absolutely nothing, so it's either Water Z or Dark Z. Probably Water Z or Mystic Water, like I said, but probably Z-move. So Haye is gonna be forced. No, Ash Ketchum Gamer is gonna be forced out. He can go into his Clefable here because nothing else wants to take. Nothing else wants to come in on a Scald. So I assume he's just gonna go Clef. He can also go Tren, but I don't think Tren wants to come in because it would have to take Rocks and Scald, and would be annoying for him. So Clef is most likely gonna come out here, and I think Haye. Haye has a few potential plays here. He can pull a double, like if his Greninja is Protean, he can double into his Greninja here, predicting the Clef. If he has Gunk Shot, he can go double into Gren and put in work from there. He can also double into Heatran potentially on the Clef, or he can just Scald or Toxic Spikes. Like, he has a lot of options. Ash Ketchum Gamer goes for Hydro Pump there, which makes no sense in my opinion. I guess he predicted Haye to pull a double. I guess he predicted him to double into Heatran. I think that's also a play I suggested, potentially one of the plays. But if you think about it, if you're Haye, it's still early game. You think out, like, you can afford to play safe here. Like, either Scald or Toxic Spikes was completely safe for him. Like, double into Gren or Tren was, yes, that was an option, but he does not have to make that play at all. But yeah, I somewhat understand where you're coming from with Pump, but it didn't make too much sense. Especially if this Pex had Toxic, your Greninja would have been crippled right there. Not that this Greninja is going to be winning anyway with Pex and Clef in the back. Like, both of these mons are going to be stopping this. So yeah, he tries to predict the double into Tren there, I think, and it doesn't work. And now he's going to be forced out, most likely into his Clef, or I don't think Pharaoh or Tren are going to want to come out. So yeah, Clef comes out, gets Toxic there, which is good for him, just because now his Clef cannot get T-Waved from the opposing Clef. And now Haye pulls a double into Greninja, which covers the Clef. And it's unlikely that Ash is going to stay in again, because he just stayed in. And now if you're Ash here, this is tough, because if this is Protean Greninja with the right coverage, it destroys you. I'm actually a really huge fan of Protean Greninja. I think it needs to be used way more. It bobs these type of teams. Ice Beam, HP Fire, Gunk Shot, or it has Low Kick over HP Fire works as well versus this team. Like, this team doesn't have much to defend versus that. And then you can also run in the last slot, you can either run Spikes, which will let you spike up on opposing Toxapex, or you can run Z-move like Z-Big or Z-Shattered Psych to lure in Toxapex. But yeah, if this is Protean, Haye can just attack here like Gunk Shot or HP Fire predicting the Pharaoh. But if he's Ash Ninja, then I think he doesn't want to stay in. And if he's Ash Ninja, he most likely wants to switch out into one of these three boys. Ash Ketchum Gamer could softball here if he wants to play it safe, because he can live any one hit most likely. Another potential play is just throwing up the rocks or going into Ferrothorn to scout for the Greninja set. Haye switched out into Heatran, which confirms that he's most likely Battle Bond and not Ash, because if he was Ash Greninja, If he was proting Greninja, I mean, he probably would have had a move to touch the clef. Ash Ketchum Gamer just threw up the rocks there. Like, he could have lived any one hit, so I guess it was an okay play. But yeah, Heatran, that was a good play on high. Comes in for free and clef, gets some leftovers recovery. And also would have covered Ash going into Ferrothorn if he wanted to scout for the Greninja being like Gunshot, or if he wanted to scout for something like Gunshot. Now, obviously, Ash Ketchum Gamer doesn't want to stay, and he just revealed Stealth Rock. So it's Stealth Rock, Soft Belt, Moonblast is what I'm thinking, and the last move could be a coverage move, or it could be Calm Mind. We will have to see that later in the game. I'm thinking it's probably common for win condition. But yeah, this Heatran, I don't remember what it revealed yet. I hate this about replays. If you hover over the mons, it doesn't like show you what they revealed so far. But basically, Ash Ketchum Gamer, the reason why Hai got up the T-Spec earlier, even though it only hits the Greninja, now the Greninja cannot come into the Heatran anymore. Because it will get bopped by Magma Storm plus rocks plus toxic spikes. So now Ash Ketchum Gamer is forced to switch into his Lardy. So what Hai can do here is can either Magma Storm to just weaken the Lardy, see what his opponent wants to do, or he can, if he has toxic on his Heatran, he can throw off a toxic. If he doesn't have anything to touch the Lardy, then he can also pull a double here, but he doesn't have to do that. He can just attack because the Lardy's gonna have to take rocks and chip. So I'm pretty sure Hai is either gonna Magma Storm or Toxic, or if he doesn't have any of that, he can pull a double. So it is just Magma Storm and he misses. So this Lardy is most likely gonna be Roost, and then either Defog 2 attacks or 3 attacks. Most likely 3 attacks. Which means it could be Surf, Ice Beam. The last move could be HP Fire to help with the Kartana matchup. T-Bolt is another option. And now, Hai can, if he has Toxic, he can still stay in and go for it, because I assume this is probably a bulky Spadeftran with leftovers, or at least max HP. If he doesn't want to let the Heatran get low, risking letting it take a Surf, or if he doesn't have Toxic, then he's obviously forced out. He could just go into his Clefable. Clefable having T-Whip is just amazing, even if this has CM for some reason, which I don't think it has CM. Clef can just come out and T-Wave the Lardy. Yeah, I guess unless it's sub-CM, but it's like super unlikely. On a team like this, you definitely want the Lardy to have like 3 attacks. Like HP Fire would be amazing to help with Kartana matchup, like I said. So like I said, play here for high is either go Clefable, or if you have Toxic on Trend, you can go for that. Ash Ketchum Gamer's play here is either to go for Surf, just to get the Mega off and get more bulk. Or another potential play, or you can double out here. But you don't really have a great double. Yeah, you don't really have a double. I think you just want to get the Mega off here. So he does just Mega. Hai stays in, which makes me think that he most likely has Toxic on his Heatran, and he does show Toxic. Ash Ketchum Gamer went for T-Bolt there, which I don't really understand that play. I guess he might have predicted Toxapex or the Greninja. Toxapex would have eaten that up anyway. Greninja, yes, would have taken damage from that, but Hai had no reason to go into Greninja, and exactly. If the Lardy is CM stored power, Hai has Gren for it. If the Lardy is just not CM 3 attacks, then he has like Clef. But yeah, he should have always surfed there just in case this Trend has Toxic, and that then he would have at least weakened the Trend. Now he got no damage on the Trend, and his Lardy is Toxic on a timer. So this is really bad for Ash Ketchum Gamer. And now Hai can just switch out into his Clef, and he got what he wanted. He got the Lardy on a timer, which is one of the best. Like, he has the Lardy on a timer, and he does a T-Spike up for the Gren. So this is, Hai is in an amazing position right now. So he can just go Clef here. I don't remember all the moves Heatran showed yet. I think it showed Magma Storm, Rocks, and Toxic. So it's either not Taunt or not Earth Power. I think either Taunt or Earth Power is going to be the last move on this Heatran. We'll have to see that later. I'm still thinking Earth Power is probably better because it hits Blacephalon. Actually, you have checks for Blacephalon, but Earth Power still hits opposing Heatran. Toxic is really cool on this overall because it hits like the checks. It also hits Mega Alakazam that people like to bring in on Heatran, especially if they find out your leftovers are not Z-move. People like to bring in Alakazam on this. But yeah, now the play for Hai is most likely just go Clef. Ash Ketchum Gamer is either gonna go for Surf or double out, I guess, into Ferro predicting Clef. He does just go for Surf. Yeah, he should have done that the first turn. Like I said, I don't agree with him doing that, T-bolting the Trend. That was like nonsense. It was a misplay for sure. So Clef Doesn't have to fear anything from the Lari, even if that has psychic or something. I assume the Lari is just gonna be forced out. So, Hedron, Pharaoh, or Clef can come out. I assume he might not want to go Clef, he might want to go either Tren or... He might want to go one of these two, because he doesn't want the Pharaoh to get T-Wave. Well, unless he's terrible. If he's terrible, I guess he might appreciate getting T-Wave. But yeah, Hai is completely free here to just click Moonblast this turn. If he has Command, that's also a potential play. Does he have a double that covers everything? He doesn't have to make a double at this point. I think Hai is completely free to either Moonblast or Softbolt or Calm Mind, whatever he wants to do or has. So Ash Ketchum Gamer goes into his... He does pull a double into Hedron. Really good play, so he flexes on his opponent. He knows that Ash Ketchum Gamer is not going to stay in here. He's either going to go to his own Clef or his Pharaoh's Zone, and Hedron covered both. And even if he doubled to his Hedron is paralyzed, which means Hai is Hedron outspeeds it and can bop it with Earth Power. So he did have a double that covered everything, and he made that double. So Hai is playing well. Also, the T-Wave is clutch for him. The Toxic was also clutch on the Hedron. He has the correct tags. Yeah, like the matchup, like it looked even at first, but Hai's sets seem to be way better in this matchup. And doubling into Hedron also makes it... Yeah, actually, I completely agree with not just Moonblasting. Because if he just Moonblasted into the Pharaoh's Zone, Ash Ketchum Gamer could have gotten up a spike. But instead, he pressures his opponent with a double into Hedron. He doesn't care about rocks too much because he has leftovers. And now the Pharaoh's Zone is going to be forced out, which gives Hai leftovers back that cancels out the rocks. Two turns of leftovers cancels out the rocks, if I'm not mistaken. So now, since the Lari is toxic, it can also not come in like that well on the Hedron. So Hai is super free to just click Magma Storm here. And Ash Ketchum Gamer is going to have to switch into the Lari, or I guess into land. He does double. Oh my god, calm down, dude. He does double into Greninja, predicting the Lari. Yeah, Ash Ketchum Gamer had to go into Lari, he didn't have another switch in. Like, I guess Landorus would have lived the Magma barely, but it was not a good play. Lari was the most likely play. Magma Storm plus Toxic plus Magma Storm secondary effect plus Rocks would have destroyed this Lari anyway, so I think that would have been a fine play. But doubling out is an even better flex, so Hai is like, I could just Magma Storm, but let me flex on this guy. Doubles into Greninja, which is obviously also a good play, but he didn't have to make the play, but it's amazing. I love how Hai is playing this, actually. Good God, this poor guy is getting destroyed. Now, he's forced out. He just took rocks plus toxic chip, which means if Hai keeps this up, the Lari cannot check the Hedron anymore at all. So if Hai wants to flex here, he doubles back into Hedron, because he's a Clef or Pharaoh is going to come out. He could actually do that if he wanted to, double back into Hedron. Or he could... just throw off a Dark Pulse or go for spikes if he has that. But I assume... Yeah, it's either Dark Pulse or double back into Hedron here. Ash Ketchum Gamer obviously doesn't want to stay in and give him Ash form. As he doubles into Hedron on the Pharaoh Thorn. Huge flex. This guy is getting outplayed as shit. Also, again, the reason Hai is making this plays, doubling into Hedron on Pharaoh Thorn ensures that Ash Ketchum Gamer cannot get up spikes. Because spikes would annoy the, like these three mons get hit by spikes. They could actually be really annoying for him. And rocks damage is really not too bad for Hai, like I said earlier, because he has those leftovers. Two turns of leftovers cancels out rocks. Now, Hai can either flex on him super hard and double back into Greninja on the most likely Lari, or he can just Magma Storm. I think at this point you just want to Magma Storm because the Lari is already chipped so hard, and you want to stay in with the Hedron to get some leftovers back, because if you keep doubling, you will keep taking rocks damage and Hedron will get super low. So Magma Storm comes out, and you guys can see that Lari barely takes, is barely alive with all the secondary effect. So now Hai can just stay in here and spam Magma Storm for a bit. He just has to be careful that he doesn't waste all the Magma PP. I think he used two Magma Storms so far. I'm not 100% sure on that. So he can either go hard Gren. Another potential play is also going Lari, because opposing, like, Mega Lari usually doesn't carry Draco, which means Mega Latios can actually take Ice Beams and Skeleton it out. But I think, yeah, that's probably not a play that he's gonna make. I think he's either gonna go Gren or just Magma Storm again. Magma Storm again is also a fine play, because the Toxic is gonna rack up. Ash Ketchum Gamer, yeah, it's just gonna recover. I wanted to just say that. So Toxic plus Magma Storm secondary effect plus Magma Storm that he does hits keeps the Lari low, And Hai stays in here for a bit, just wants to get his leftovers recovery. I think he used 4 Madness Stone PP now, so he has 4 left if I'm not mistaken. So eventually Hai is probably going to switch out because he doesn't want to use all his Magma Stones, but he got all the leftovers back right now. Ashkatchen Game has forced to keep recovering, and yeah. So what Hai can do here, he can either go into Clefable, or he can go into Greninja. Clefable is probably the safer play because you don't want to risk this going for T-Bolt on the incoming Greninja. Even though if he goes for T-Bolt, he would probably die at this point to Toxic if he doesn't recover. So he's most likely just going to recover here. So I guess he could go to one of these two. Magma Storm again is an option, but if he does just Magma again, I think, yeah. But eventually he's going to switch into one of these two. I think he only has 3 Magma Storm PP left now, if I counted correct. Now he brings in the Hard Greninja, huge flex on the obvious recover. Doesn't even go Clef, goes Hard Gren. And now Ferrothorn is at full, so it's most likely that Ferrothorn is going to come out. Clef could also come out because Clef covers the Dark Pulse. Now, Hai could double back into Heatran just to not let the Ferrothorn come in for free and get up spikes. That's another reason why he had to keep Magma Storm PP, because if he uses all his Magma Storms, the Ferrothorn would wall the Heatran if it only has like Earth Power or whatever left in the last slot. If it doesn't have Magma Storm. So that's why he had to keep some to prevent the Ferrothorn from spiking. I guess if he has Taunt, he can still prevent it from spiking, but I assume the last move is going to be Earth Power. If it's Earth Power and not Taunt, that means the Pex has to be Haste, because otherwise opposing CM Clef destroys Hai's team. We didn't see that yet, but I assume it's Haze anyway on the Pex. He only showed T-Spikes so far. But yeah, Ashkatchen Game has forced out here because he cannot afford to give the Greninja Battle Bond, because then afterwards it would just destroy his team. So he has to go into one of these two. And Hai can, yeah, either attack with Dark Pulse or I guess go for Spikes if he has that. Or he can double back in the Heatran. I think double back in the Heatran is a good play because it just doesn't let his opponent breathe at all. If he does double back in the Heatran on the Ferrothorn slash Clef. Dude, amazing. I don't do this too often that I like get so excited watching these watching someone play, but I love how he's not letting off the pressure, right? Like, he has a good matchup, he has the T-Wave tech, he has the Toxic tech, and yeah, like, he has the tools, but he uses them right. Like, some people use them wrong, and he makes the doubles he has to make that are risk-free. Because, like, let me pause it real quick. I just paused it to change up the music. Yeah, basically this double was super risk-free because the Latias could just not stay in, he cannot afford to give him Battle Bond. And also, the Latias was on a timer from Toxic, right? If anything, if it stays in, it would recover. It would not attack there. So Heatran was completely fine double. Just to ensure that the Ferrothorn cannot come in for free and get up spikes. So now Ashkatchen Gamer, I don't know what he wants to do here, honestly. Yes, Protect, that's a potential play, but otherwise, he might have to switch. I guess he could go into Clefable at this point, because he knows that this Heatran is Rocks, Magma Storm, Toxic. Last move is either Taunt or Earth Power. Probably is Earth Power, like I said. So if that is the case, that would mean the opposing Clef would actually be able to come in on this. I don't know if Hai even wants to go for Magma Storm, because like I said, he has to be careful with the Magma Storm PP. I think he only has 3 left if I counted correct. So, Yeah, so for Ash, it's either Protect. I don't know if Latias can even come in after with Rocks Up and Magma Storm and Toxic. So another play might just be him. Like, it's either Protect or go into Clef or Latias for Ashkatchen Gamer. He doubles back into Greninja, anticipating the Latias to come out, as Ashkatchen Gamer does show Protect. So I don't think Hai had to make that double, but I understand where he's coming from, obviously. Now, what's it called? The Protect tech allowed Ashkatchen Gamer to catch Hai on a double right there. And now he's free to get up a spike if he has spikes. If he doesn't have spikes, I guess he could click knockoff or leech seed here. I would click knockoff if I don't have spikes, because knockoff also hits the incoming Clef, because Clef could block leech seed. But yeah, Hai just goes back trend, but I assume Ash is just gonna throw up a spike. Let's see what he does. Yeah, he does get up a spike. So at one point later in the game, Hai is probably gonna want to defog. Maybe he wants to wait until the Greninja gets affected by toxic spikes and then he can defog. The spike is not too big of a deal because he has regen on his pecs. Magic Guard on Clef, and these mons also don't get affected by spikes. This one has leftovers, so it's not too bad. If multiple layers get up, it can be annoying, but at the moment it's still fine for him. So I think Haya is probably gonna wanna click either Rocks of Power or Taunt here, because the Protect is really obvious, and like I said, he only has a few Magma Storm PP left. So that's why I thought he wouldn't want to go for Magma Storm, but he does go for Magma Storm actually. So that's the first play probably that I don't agree with that he made, but overall he's playing the Super Fire. Because he already showed Protect, so why would you use up a Magma Storm PP? I guess he was trying to catch him on a stay and on a non-Protect. But yeah, Protect was pretty obvious. So now he only has two Magma Storm PP left, if I counted that correct. So at this point, he has to be a little bit careful with that. I don't know if he wants to Magma Storm again, because like I said, he only has two left. Ash Ketchum Gamer obviously doesn't want to stay in here. I assume either the Clef or the Lardy is going to come out here. Let's go into Lardy. If he off-pulls or Magma Storms, he Magma Storms, which means he only has one left. But I think that kills the Lardy, actually. So great for them. I love how he played that earlier. Like, he kept doubling around, even though it didn't work one time because of the Protect. But other than that, it worked perfectly fine. Chipping down Toxic plus Rocks plus Magma Storm, hitting plus secondary effect from Magma Storm. Chipped down the Lardy so much. But now I think he only has one Magma Storm left. Maybe two if I counted wrong. So he has to be careful, otherwise the Pharaoh is going to wall this and get up free spikes on this. Because last move, like I said, either off power or taunt, probably off power. Now, he probably doesn't want to go Greninja because then it would get Toxic spiked. So I think he's just going to go into his Landorus here to scare out the Heatran, exactly. And Hai obviously is not going to stay in here. Hai is... what does he go to here? I think he either goes Lando or Clef. I think Clef is okay here because... I don't think you want to go Lando on a potential HP Ice and get barbed because you want the Lando around to defog. And if the Clef gets Earthquake, that's not too bad. It's one of these three. It's either Clef or Landorus. I think Ash Ketchum Gamer is just going to U-turn. Yeah, I agree completely with going Clef. Because like I said, you don't want to go Lando and get HP Ice. And if Clef gets Earthquake, it's not too big of a deal. You can still switch out into either this or this. Depending on what you want to cover. Let's say he Earthquakes there and the Clef gets quite low. Then the next turn his Ash Ketchum Gamer is probably going to have to pull a double out. And Haye could probably think that through and then cover that. And like he can still double the Clef in back later in the game to get leftovers back. So that would not be the end of the world. And it was super unlikely that Ash would just Earthquake there into the opposing Landorus. So now... Clef, Pharaoh, or Heatran is gonna come out here. Goes in the Ferrothorn, so I assume he just wants to lay up more spikes. I don't think he wants to T-Wave this actually, just in case it has Jarable, because they would power up the Jarable. And also, if you T-Wave this, he cannot burn it, because later in the game, if he throws off Scalds, that can potentially burn the Ferrothorn. Because Ash Ketchum Gamer actually has no good Scald switch-ins. I guess Clef is a Scald switch-in, but Clef cannot touch the Pex back, and Pex has more PP than Clef. Yeah, I assume he's just gonna throw up a spike here, and Tai reveals to be Calm Mind now, which I was already expecting him to be. And now Ash Ketchum Gamer is actually, like, Ferrothorn is set up for the 4 Clefable. So Ash Ketchum Gamer actually, his Heatran is paralyzed, if I remember correctly, so it cannot beat this Clef well with the CM boost now. So if his own Clefable is Calm Mind, he has to go to that and Calm Mind up right now. If he is not Calm Mind on his own Clef, I think he just loses straight up to this. He goes Heatran. Does his Heatran have Taunt? I think it's gonna have Taunt, yeah, but since he's paralyzed, this Clef actually outspeeds and it's gonna give him a hard time. So he does show Taunt, but now this Clef is at plus 3. Hai can Moonblast here once if he wants to get some chip on the Heatran. I think this Heatran showed leftovers already, right? And yeah, it's pretty obvious that the Greninja is the Z-move user just from the damage that the Greninja did earlier in the game. Yeah, let me know in the comments if you guys like this. I went super into detail in this. Like, I could just be playing this faster. I'm gonna play it faster soon because it's gonna be pretty obvious what's going on. So Heatran is getting chipped down, and Clef doesn't really mind the Magma Storm chip. He got a special attack dropped there, and now Ash Ketchum Gamer sees that his Heatran would lose 1v1 to the Clefable and goes into his own Clefable. And this has to be CM, like I said, otherwise he if it's not CM, he can just forfeit and he loses right on the spot here, unless he just, I guess, crits it with the Greninja, which even if he goes Gren, High could potentially go Pex on the pump. Nah, he wouldn't go Gren. Yeah, so he has to go Clef and he has to Calm Mind up. I'm pretty sure he is Calm Mind the way he brought this in, otherwise this just wouldn't make any sense. So you have a Calm Mind war here, and he scouted out what his opponent wants to do to beat this Clef, and we found out that the Heatran cannot beat the Clef, so now he went into his own Clef. And pretty much this is a crit war, like which Clef crits first wins this 1v1, and now High is just attacking once to weaken the opposing Clef. But I think what High should be doing, if he has Haze on his Pex, he should just go out to his Pex. Like, he attacked a few times there to make sure that Ash waged some soft balls, which is completely fine by High. But eventually I think he should just go into Pex and Haze this if he has Haze, which he should have, because High's team is it is quite weak to opposing Clefable, because I don't think he has Taunt on the Heatran. I said this two or three times already. I think the last move on Heatran is Earth Power. So High, since he's not a plus 6 yet, the opposing Clef, I understand that High is just attacking him. Because Ash should keep Calm Minding, and Ash Moonblasted a few times even though he wasn't at plus 6, which I think was a misplay, wasting Moonblast PP. Honestly, like I said this already, it's a hard matchup for Ash, I think. Like, after the sets were revealed, High has the better matchup, I think. The techs were just amazing that he has, Toxic and T-Wave. But eventually High goes into his Pecs now, which I think he could have done a bit earlier, but it was fine. Like, it was fine how he played it. And now he's most likely gonna Haze. Ash gets lucky there with a crit and still does nothing to Pex. Well, not nothing, but it only does half. Now High is free to click recover here, keep his Pex healthy to make sure that the opposing Greninja doesn't become too big of an issue. Ash uses this as an opportunity to go Ferrothorn and throw up a spike, but now High can fish for the burn on the Ferrothorn. This is what I talked about earlier. Ash has no good switch-ins for Scald, and eventually the Ferrothorn is gonna get burned here. If the Ferrothorn gets burned, it will get chipped down from rocks plus burn, which means burn cancels out the leftovers, as there is the burn, and rocks would do, whenever Ferro comes in, 6%. So in the long run, this Ferrothorn is just gonna die out, because High goes in the Clef here, which blocks the Leech Seed. That's what I was just gonna say. Like, I was gonna say that, but then he made that play already. Going into Clef is what he can always do on the Ferrothorn after he burns the Ferrothorn, because the Ferro cannot touch the Clef at all, even if it has Gyro Ball. Which I didn't reveal it, if it's Power Whip or Gyro Ball. I think it might be Power Whip, I don't know. Even if it's Gyro Ball, like I said, Clef wards that with ease. Even if it's not burned, but burn it wards it even easier. And Clef has Magic Guard, which always prevents Ferrothorn from getting health back with Leech Seed. So he doubles into Landorus here. I wanted to explain the turn, what he could do here, but I already let it play. So what did he predict here, doubling into Landorus? I think he predicted the Heatran. He predicted either the Heatran or... because what else would coming out on the Clef? Yeah, he predicted either the opposing Clef or the Heatran, and he doubled this Landris in. Predicting either Clef or Heatran, and now I assume, yeah, he just wants to go for the Defog, because there were three layers of spikes. He could have potentially waited for Ash to bring out the opposing Greninja and let it get poisoned by T-Spike before he did this, but this is also fine for High. So now it's pretty obvious that... High is either gonna go Heatran or Pex, Ash Ketchum Gamer is just gonna throw the rocks back up. High goes to his Tran and is gonna get his rocks back up. Since this opposing Clef doesn't have heat T-Wave, High doesn't have to fear anything here, and he just goes in the Pex. CMing up absolutely does nothing for Ash. It does nothing. Like, I get that he's trying to do something. He has to play for the choke, I guess, but High is free, he can do whatever he wants. As you guys can see, he just T-Spiked there because this Clef is such a non-threat. Like, he can T-Spike or Scald even here to potentially catch a switch. He doesn't have to Haze. If this gets to plus 4, plus 3, plus 5, maybe he can eventually Haze. But you guys can see he just Scalds. He doesn't have to fear the Moonblast. Now he might want to Haze or then turn after. He just wastes the Moonblast there, which I don't think he should have done that. But, like, to be honest, what else would he have done? Because if he goes Ferrothorn, which he does now, I was going to say that... like, what else would he do? If he goes Ferrothorn, High doubles into Heatran there. Which, the reason why he did that, I already explained it earlier. He doubles into Heatran. doubling into Heatran on Clef is really safe, because if Clef stays in, it either CMs or Moonblasts, which Heatran doesn't care about. If it CMs, then you can still switch back into Pharaoh. If it Moonblasts, it doesn't know nothing. And if he goes Pharaoh, you have one Magma PP left, I think, and you can scare this out, prevent it from spiking up again, because Landorus cannot defog infinitely, because it only, like, it will get chipped eventually, like, it took rocks once already. It cannot keep defogging, so you want to make sure that he doesn't just set up spikes in your face for free. so I assume he's just going to click Earth Power or Taunty, whatever his last move, probably Earth Power. He has no point protecting, really, because the burn cancels out the leftovers recovery. And now Ash goes into Clef, since the Ladi is dead and the Greninja would get poisoned by T-Spikes. He doesn't want to go to that, and obviously he doesn't want to get bopped by Earth Power going Trent. And yeah, Hai now confirms that he's Earth Power, not Taunt, in the last slot, which I was already thinking about the entire game. Thought he was dead. And now the Clef, since this only has one Magma Storm left and doesn't have Taunt, we know that the Clef walls this. So there's no reason to waste the last Magma Storm. I think he only has one left, if I counted correct, so Hai is probably going to switch out here. I guess Ash could potentially double into the Pharaoh here, predicting Hai to switch into the Clef or the Toxapex and then get up Spike. Like, he has to try something. Another play here, which would be either Moonblast or Command, there's absolutely nothing for him. Like, and now Hai is probably... Hai is free now to just double back into Heatran. That's the play he has been making. Because, like I said, if the Clef stays in here, Heatran eats Moonblast with ease. And if he goes for Command, Hai doesn't care. You can switch into Pex later when this sets up more. It's not a threat. And Heatran here will just cover a double into Ferrothorn. So I think he's completely free to pull that double again, as he does make that play exactly. Ash goes for Command. Does not matter at all. Hai can click off Power once here, I guess. Or he can just switch back into his Toxapex. I think clicking, yeah, he just switches back into Toxapex. I was gonna say clicking off power once would have also been a fine play. I guess going back to Pex is fine there, just in case he Calm Minds again. You don't wanna get this out of hand with spamming Calm Mind. But even if it Calm Minded again, I think it still would have been fine staying in for one more turn and then switching next turn to Pex. And now he can either go for Haze here, or he can go back into Heatran. Back into Heatran, I think, is a fine play, just because it would catch the Ferrothorn, as he does make the play again. Really big fan of how he's playing this. Now he scares us out again, and he's most likely just gonna click Earth Power. Like I said, no reason to protect, but he does protect. I guess it stalls out the Earth Power PP, okay. I guess there's some reason to protect, but he just gives the Heatran leftovers recovery. Now you're forced back into Clef, knowing that Clef walls this, and you have nothing that else wants to come in. I guess Lando could came out, but Lando coming in would be fine for Hai. It would take rocks, which is free chip for Hai. Greninja doesn't want to come out, because it would take Toxic Specs plus rocks plus Earth Power. And now Hai is free to, like, he can either attack again or he can switch back, exactly, either Clef or Pex. I guess the reason Ash Ketchum Gamer is going for Moonblast is if Hai goes into his Clef, that chips it down a little bit and forces Hai to go for Softboiled. Hai can double back to Tren here, or he can Softboiled, but I assume he just went for Softboiled. The reason why he had to Softboiled at one point is because he needs this healthy kind of to have a safe switch into the opposing Scarf Landorus. Like, if it's at 54, I think it would be a bit too low. So I get why he had to heal. But now I think he should go back in the Heatran, just because if this CMs again, it doesn't matter. He can go Pex later still, and it would still catch Ash Ketchum Gamer doubling into Ferrothorn. He Moonblast there, which I don't really understand, but to be fair, what else is he gonna do? Like, he has to hope for some choke. So did he make the double, or did he just haze? He did make the double on the Heatran, preventing Ash Ketchum Gamer from getting up free spikes. Okay, I really just gotta let this go playing. As he clicks rocks, they're predicting Ash Ketchum Gamer to go for Protect, or I predicted him to switch into Clef. And he didn't want to waste another Earth Power PP. And Ash Ketchum Gamer, I think he predicted him to not Magma Storm. He predicted him to either Earth Power or... Yeah, he predicted him to Earth Power. Or to not Magma Storm, basically, because he only has one or two Magma Storms left. And I think he went for Spikes. Yeah. So finally get some sort of... get something going, gets a spike back up, but this doesn't matter. So now he goes in the Clef on a Earth Power. And Hai is free to either go into his Pex or his Clef. And he goes into his Clef. Ash Ketchum Gamer doubles into Landorus there, predicting what? He doubles into Landorus here. Trying to catch the Toxapex, maybe? I'm not... Or the Heatran. Trying to catch Toxapex or Heatran, I'm not 100% sure. But he just took rocks. And... He's gonna have to U-turn out here, because if he stays in Earthquake, bounces off, and he gets weakened by Moonblast, so there's no reason to stay in. So U-turn out into one of these three, goes into this. Moonblast is really good for high, good chip on the Clef. Even if you went Ferrothorn in there, he would have had to take rocks plus Moonblast, and Clef blocks Leech Sheet, which means he would just get chipped down more. And now high is completely free to go back into his Heatran. Actually, no. So the reason why high is not free to go into Heatran anymore now is because there's spikes plus rocks, which means Heatran would get chipped a little bit more. So at one point high is gonna want to defog, I guess, maybe. The reason why high is combining up now, I think, is I guess he wants Ash Ketchum Gamer to use up some PP, and then he just goes into Pex, which is the correct play. If he combines up to plus 6, that would be the wrong play. Because if both go to plus 6, then high would risk his Clef getting crit. Since he has a Haze Pex that walls the opposing Clef, he has no reason to risk anything. So he can just Scald or Haze here, or T-Spike, or whatever he wants to do, as he does just Haze. Now he can go back to Tren, or he can throw off a Scald. If Ash Ketchum Gamer goes hard into Landorus, I think predicting the Tren, high just throws off a Scald, which was completely free, does not get the burn, but gets a good chip on the Landorus. Now Ash Ketchum Gamer is most likely going to U-turn. He could also Earthquake, but Clef can take everything, so high makes the correct play. He U-turns out into Ferrothorn, but this is free chip, free rocks chip on Ferrothorn for high. This Ferro is slowly going to die down. I think he could have Moonblasted there to just chip it a bit, but Common is also a fine play. Now I think he should Moonblast, because if he chips this, this would be good for him. If he goes to Clef, that also does a good amount. Tren would also have to take rocks plus Moonblast chip. Hard into Landris here, predicting Softbolt or Calm Mind. But now, I don't know why he went Landris there. Unless he predicted a switch into one of these two. Now, I don't know why he went Landris there. Maybe he wants to get the defog off, but on there, that was not the play, I don't think. So now he's probably just gonna U-turn out. He's probably just gonna U-turn out into this, or into probably just Toxapex here. Because if Ash Ketchum Gamer switches, he gets momentum. If this stays in, Pex is free. And if he's probably gonna Softboiled, Moonblast, yeah, Moonblast was also fine. And yeah, I get right. He Moonblast there because if high defogged, the Landorus would have either died or taken like 50 or 60. Like, the Landorus would have been super low, which I completely understand why he did that. And it was out of range from Earthquake anyway. So it makes sense. It made sense. So now high is free to click Scald, or yeah, I think Scald is fine here. Or it could also click Haze. He doesn't have to click Haze though. He does click Haze. Now he's free to click Scald. But yeah, the double into that he made into Heatran earlier, now he's not making that double anymore because of the spikes that the opponent got up. Like, because Heatran would get chipped too much, right? So that's why he's not making the double that he made earlier anymore. Yeah, like I said, let me know in the comments if you just want me to do the replay quicker. But I think this is cool going in depth, kind of, but now it's kind of repetitive at this point. So what happened here? Goes Ferrothorn. Clef is honestly free to just Moonblast or Calm Mind here. Moonblast is Moonblast exactly, because that's 10% chip on Ferrothorn. And Ferrothorn is never getting any health back. Like I said, Burn is cancelling out leftovers. Every time it comes in, it has to take rocks, and it takes Moonblast, and this can block Leech Seed with Magic Guard. So now he gets up all the layers, so eventually High wants to defog them, obviously. He does double into Landris here, anticipating the Heatran or Clefable to come out here. As Ash Ketchum Gamer goes in the Clef. So Ash Ketchum Gamer is just going to Moonblast here because in case the land defogs, he wants to weaken the Landris. Because Moonblast, I think that's like 30 or 40. 39, yeah. So now he got the Landris low. High got rid of the spikes. So now that High got rid of the spikes, he can keep going Heatran more often again. Ash Ketchum Gamer is just going to throw the rocks up again. High is just going to go Heatran here to get his rocks back up. We already had this earlier after he defogged. The rocks are just going to get set back up. So he's just going to Calm Mind. So high is free to click either Earth Power or go to Pex. He decides to go to Pex. Moonblast doesn't do anything for him. I guess he's just hoping for some choke. Now Scald is super free for high. Haze is an option. Doubles back into Tren. Yeah, okay. I didn't mention it earlier. I did talk about it. But now, like I said, Now that the spikes are off, only rocks are on high side again. He can afford to make this double enter trend. I kind of got off there, right? Because the video is getting super long. It's a slow mistake, little mistake on my end there. Yeah, double enter Heatran was the correct play. Because if Clef stays in, Heatran doesn't care about it. If Ferrothorn comes out, you prevent it from spiking up more and the Ferro is getting chipped. You're free to click Earth Power here with the Heatran, or double back is also an option. Just click Earth Power, gets a nice crit right there. And now, you can Earth Power again, or you can switch out into Pex or his own Clef. And yeah, he makes him use another softball there, which is really cool. Unfortunately, like I said, I cannot hover over it and see how many softball PP it has left. That's a bit annoying. High is free to click Scald here or double back to Heatran. Doubles back to Heatran just in case Ash Ketchum Gamer wants to go Pharaoh. Also, every time Ash Ketchum Gamer goes Pharaoh, he would take, like I said, he takes 6% from rocks. Doubles back to Pex, they're predicting a Calm Mind. And now he's free to either Scald or double back in the Heatran. I think double back in the Heatran is better because it does not let the spike. Gets up a T-Spike, also fine. So now Ash Ketchum Gamer is gonna get up a spike here most likely. High just goes in the Clef because that is the correct play. Because in case he Leech Seeded that, trying to get health back with his Ferrothorn. This blocks the Leech Seed, makes it so that Ferrothorn stays low, and now he's free to click Moonblast or Calm Mind. Just clicks Moonblast. Completely fine because it either gets chip on this, this, or this. And if any chip is great for High, because that just makes this that so that this eventually has to go for softballed, even though it has lefties going for it. So he's free to Scald here or double back in the Heatran. I think double back in the Heatran is a bit better, honestly. Let's just click Haze, also a fine play. Now he's probably just gonna go Clef again to block a Leech Seed from this. Ash can go for a spike here, I guess. But yeah, the spikes don't really matter too much for High, like I said, between these two. The spikes only matter for the Heatran. Like, Heatran cannot double in as much with spikes up, but it's fine. So, we're gonna see softball. No, Moonblast or Calm Mind here from Ash Ketchum Gamer. Softballs, which was a misplay. I said it at first, but I think you should only softball when you're lower with the Clef. You should be a bit more careful with his softballs. But no matter what, this game is a wrap. This game has been over for a fat minute. High is in a huge. Has a huge advantage, is in a better position. So, he's free to double back in the Heatran here or throw off his Scald to chip down the Ferrothorn. He doesn't want to double the Heatran because of the spikes, but I think he could have still done it once because he's still quite healthy and he would get back leftovers. So now he can just go Clef every time to prevent this from Leech Seeding. Ash can get up the last layer if he wants here, doesn't really matter. High is free to click Moonblast or Calm Mind, probably Moonblast because it's a really good chip on the Clef, gets a juicy ass crit there. So what is he going to go here? Calm Mind? Softballs, why is he always softballing when he's at 60? That makes no sense, dude. You don't have to softball, like, hello? Like, I guess he wants to keep this healthy to switch into opposing Moonblasts because he just got critted at 40, but I don't think he had to do that. But also, I don't think it matters too much. I just like how High played this Super Fire overall. He had the tools to win, he used them right. Scald there makes it super low. Now he goes back to Clef if he makes the right play because it blocks the Leech Seed and keeps the Ferrothorn low. Ferrothorn, like, it either has Jarball or Power, we don't know that yet, but it doesn't have Knockoff, which is also good for High that he doesn't have Knockoff, so he keeps the leftovers on this. So High is free to click Moonblast or Calm Mind here, probably Moonblast. Clicks Calm Mind in this case, okay. Now he can Calm Mind again, which forces Ash Ketchum, exactly. If High Calm Mind's up, it forces Ash Ketchum Gamer to use Calm Mind with his Clef, and eventually his Clef runs out of Calm Mind. And if the opposing Clef runs out of Calm Mind, High's Clef just wins the game. So he Calm Minds up a bit, forces the opponent to Calm Mind, and then he just goes Pex and Hazes, making the opponent waste CMs. Now he can either Scald or Haze. Opponent wastes the Moonblast there, doesn't really matter. Scald staying here, he wants to switch. Now he can Haze or Scald again, probably Haze, because you don't want to play around. Ash Ketchum Gamer goes in the Heatran, does Haze. Now he is free to go into his Ladi here. Ash Ketchum Gamer hasn't brought his Heatran in a fat minute. What does he go for here? He goes for Magma Storm to weaken the Ladi. Now High is free to just go Mega Evolve and go for Roost. Ash Ketchum Gamer brings out the Clef. So now the Clef means High is either going to switch to his Pex or his Clef. Switches to his Pex. Ash Ketchum Gamer doubles in the Heatran there, expecting maybe the Clef to come out. I'm not really, because Heatran doesn't beat the Clef that well with the para. But yeah, High never wants to stay in here because this Heatran is taunt Magma Storm and it might still outspeed Pex because Pex is super slow. So he has no reason not to go Ladi here. Ash Ketchum giving doubles into Clef predicting Lari. He's trying something, but Clef is not a threat because he can just go back into Pex. Spikes and rocks does like no damage. He doubles back there. I guess he's trying something, but it doesn't really matter too much. High three to go back into his Lari here. And he misses a Magma Storm, which is a bit annoying, but even if he hit, High could have just gone for recover, so like, not a big deal. And Ash Ketchum Gamma's Trend seems to not have Toxic, because if he had it, he probably would have gone for it by now, trying to catch the Lari. And now since he missed, the Lari is actually free to go for Psychic here, and he has no good switching for that. He has a Clef, yes, but Psychic does quite a lot to that, because Clef able is Fizz Death to deal with Zygarde and Hawlucha and stuff like that better. You guys can see it does 52, he's forced to Soft Bolt. So High can either switch out here, not risking anything, or he can Psychic again. Psychic again would be fishing for the Spideff drop, because he knows the opponent is mostly going to Soft Bolt, and he does get the Spideff drop. So now this forces a kill with Psychic. Ash Ketchum Gamer is going to have to sack something, and I assume he's going to sack the Ferrothorn, because it's at 17%, at 12, 11 after rocks. So let's just Psychic get rid of that. Now we can go Lando and U-turn, or it goes Granite, let's get Toxic, okay. So obviously High doesn't want to stay in here. Even if this gets the Ash form somehow with the Z-move, he's on a timer with the T-spikes, so there's no way High can lose. High is going to switch to either Clef or Pex. I assume he's going to go Clef just because Clef is at full and has Magic Guard. That way it does not care about the spikes and the rocks, and he knows Clef can take any one hit, and he gets chipped from the Toxic. And yeah, he knew that Dark Pulse was potentially coming out because he has a Pex that resists Hydro Pump, and now High's play is just spamming Soft Bolt, because it, that way he can live Hydro Pump or Hydro Vortex, even as he does show Hydro Vortex. Yep. What did he go? Moonblast or Softball? He did just Softball, which was always the play to make. He could have also Moonblasted there and killed it, but I think Softball was the play. I completely agree with how High played this. So now this doesn't even have a Z-move anymore. So High is free to, do whatever he wants here. Moonblast or Softball again, I think, would have been fine. This Greninja was so weak. Hydro Vortex only did 77. Maybe this Clef has a little bit of Spideff, or he got a low roll there. And yeah, he just forfeits there at turn 130, knowing that he has no way of winning. Greninja is weakened. Trin is paralyzed. I think his Clef was also almost out of Soft Bolts. So the Mega Lari, or like Scarf Landris also kind of just won. Well, not yet, because there was also the opposing Lando still. But he had so many ways winning. This Clef could have also just commanded and won. When the opposing Clef runs out of command, then this Clef commanded up and just won from there. Thank you guys for watching. I did not want this video to be that long. I wanted to make this like 30 minutes. But I felt like talking about the turns in depth might be better. Especially if I have some people watching who are new to the game. I'm always happy if people can learn something. I know I'm not the best player, but I think overall this was a good narration. I guess some major mistakes, but nah, I think it was actually pretty fire. Besides like two or three little things. Thank you guys for watching. Smash the like button. Let me know if you want to see this more often. I can do replays more often where I go in depth. Because when it's replay, I have time to explain a play. I don't have to like rush when they're playing fast, when they're playing live. But like I said, I recorded game 2 and potential game 3 live for this series. Stay tuned for that. Smash the like button. And I see you guys with more content. Also go vote on Twitter for what team you want me to use in the next shot on live. A fantastic day, and I'll see you guys next time. Good God, I'm exhausted. This was way too long. Why was this so long? Like, this was longer than this was like as long as my life yesterday almost. Yeah, peace out, friends. Have a good one.